Hey everybody, guess what time it is? That's right, we're back at it again. Now, yesterday, we went after the Nintendo fanboys. Today, we're back to PlayStation. Now this video is late, mind you. But see, I've gotten some criticism about my channel. Alex, you're an X-Bot, is what I've been told. This is an Xbox channel, from what I've heard. This is all about Xbox. You never criticize Xbox, Alex. Not once have you made a video criticizing Xbox or the people defending it. Look, if you're new here, this is a PC gaming channel. I even do PC port reviews if you want to check those out. I even show games you should play on your PC. If you think that I'm going to fanboy over a piece of plastic, or even a GPU, or even a company, or even a storefront, you've got another thing coming. The point of this channel is to have it PC-centric, and then, before even that, it's consumer-centric first. So yeah, I may not have gone after Xbox fanboys on Twitter lately, but that's because they've been very quiet. They haven't really said anything outlandish. However, PlayStation fanboys... we want to see how deep the rabbit hole goes. Now, if you want to know what I'm talking about, last week, Sony acquired Nixxes. And me being the person that I am, I've played a few games that were actually ported over from console to PC from Nixxes themselves. Deus Ex Human Revolution and Mankind Divided being some of the two best games they've done. However, though, those games were also not the best ports, Mankind Divided specifically, because of the actual amount of, let's say, graphical options that almost did nothing, or the amount of hardware needed to run that game relatively well. A lot of it really wasn't well optimized. But see, here's what happened. A lot of Sony fanboys knew what was coming their way, and many others have absolutely no clue.
Look, what am I supposed to do here with this? I know, you were asleep. He broke in.
He
flipped the switch, bad wire, and lights him on fire.
Don't listen to him.
Here we see the Nixxes website, and they are joining PlayStation Studios. They said SIE announced today that they have completed the acquisition of Nixxes Software BV. Nixxes, an industry-leading Dutch studio with more than 20 years of experience in game development and optimization, based in the Netherlands. I'm not going to say the city name, it's just not going to happen. Effective immediately, Nixxes will join PlayStation Studios Technology Creative and Services Group to provide high-quality, in-house technical development capabilities for the PlayStation Studio. Do you know what that means? I'll tell you what that means. Say goodbye to your precious PlayStation exclusives, because they're not going to be exclusive anymore, baby! So, of course, the usual suspects on Twitter really thought they had something smart to say, when, of course, they almost never do. Let's go take a look. Now, you really can't talk about PlayStation fanboy copium without speaking about this person right here, Ergo84. He says, "It seems that these dudes are specializing in porting games to PC. Interesting. It's interesting that you are no longer going to be able to have your little Twitter fight every day and pull out your little checklist of games other people can't play without having to buy the plastic box that you literally go around and parade as your own identity. In fact, the copium kicks in not 10 minutes later. Damn, it didn't take long for the PC cuck army to start begging for PlayStation games after the Nixxes acquisition. You guys will always live under the shadow of PlayStation games, at least you don't try to hide it anymore." I had to go back to full screen for this one because your argument is complete horseshit. No one lives under the shadow of a PlayStation game, or even under the shadow of PlayStation at all. See, on PC, we have so many other genres to play that having to play the same third-person action-adventure game with stealth elements really isn't exciting or interesting anymore. We get frame rates that you've never honestly heard of. We get resolutions you could only dream of. We get genres and games and indie titles you wish you could actually have. And on top of that, we now get all your exclusives. That's right, we get every single game. Doesn't matter when, it just matters that it shows. And it comes to our platform no matter what. whether through emulation or whether through the company themselves, every single game that has ever been made can be played on a PC. We also don't pay for online. We get mods, we get developer support, we can use any controller, even your DualSense controller. And the fact that Sony has gone out and bought Nixxes to help with PC port development just goes to show that you and all your ilk will always live and be under the shadow of PC. From one dummy brainlet to another, they want in on the corporate slavery LOL. Too bad Sony will be treating them like second class. Moonface emoji. We're the ones being treated like second class? You mean the people that are not paying $70 for a new game? The people who don't have to pay for online? The people who are actually getting a full development studio dedicated to them for those games to come to our platform? If you want to talk being treated like second class, wouldn't it be the person who has to buy the console every few cycles to play those new games? Wouldn't it also be the person who has to pay for online? Wouldn't it also be the person playing at lower frame rate, not having graphical options? Huh, weird. Oh, and here we go again for another hot take from this same person. PS fans are the only ones that don't beg for ports. Almost like they already have the best. You have the best of what exactly? The best of the same third-person story-based action-adventure game with stealth elements? That's what you have the best of? Then keep it. I don't want it. I'm not gonna buy it. I'm just here to watch you flail, scream, and cry all over the internet and just inhale massive amount of copium so that you can actually feel like the purchase that you made for your plastic box is validated in some way. Doing this to strangers on the internet is really just the beginning stages of grief. Right now, you're in denial. Soon, you will be at acceptance. From Bozoid, Sony sold their soul to the devil Microsoft against demon Google, and Stadia was not worth the deal. I wonder if Stadia by ex-Xbox head Phil Harrison was indeed all but a plan to make PlayStation go down. What? This is the kind of mental illness that I have to deal with on a daily basis. Literally, mentally ill across the board. The demon of Xbox, the devil of Stadia, Google, the actual Satan of video games. All hail Sony, the God who will save us all who are mentally sick. And you guys wonder why I've been picking on PlayStation fanboys so much. Here's a personal fan of mine who loves me oh so very much. At Origi Greatness says, "That doesn't sound good." Oh no, it sounds great. It sounds like you can no longer have your little list of games that you claim to be exclusive. It sounds like you have to actually now develop a real personality. Something people can actually attach themselves to, besides being a corporate slave for a plastic box and a corporation. It now sounds like you actually have to develop something known as actual human interaction, which I know is going to be difficult for you across the board, because all you do is live and breathe a corpo on Twitter. Don't think of this as something bad. Think of this as a freeing moment, where you can now actually be a functioning adult and member of society. And now for something different, we're going to be doing some rapid fire tweets of PlayStation fanboys having zero idea of the impending loss of their little fictitious console war that will be coming their direction. Ready? Here we go. Cause ain't nobody heard of this random ass studio. Who the f*** is Nixxes? Let's use a comedic gif. Who? You'll know who soon, Jay Bari. You'll know. Now the video game connoisseur is back at it again, trying to do whatever he can to spin this in a positive direction for himself and his ilk. Nixxes specializes in ports and optimizations. It is like something between Bluepoint Games and Visual Arts Services Group. Would definitely help the European studios a lot by distributing work. Fire. Yeah, they're gonna help by distributing those games to PC. So here's the deal. As much as we like to troll fanboys consistently on this channel, regardless of what they like to fanboy about, the thing is this: more people get to play more games, and that's always a good thing. We can make the argument about exclusives having value or being anti-consumer another time, and I would like to get into that conversation with some other friends of mine later on. What we're actually talking about is just the amount of salt and the way people are idolizing and creating an actual identity behind a corporation. I say this every time I make this kind of content, and I continually have to bear its repetition. A company is just a company. If you like the product they make, that's great. They make a great product. Enjoy that product. Just because other people can also use parts of that product doesn't mean the value for you is now lost. You are enjoying the product that you purchased. If you like PlayStation and the products they offer, that's great. That's got nothing to do with anybody else but you. But trying to make the argument that now that someone else can play a game that doesn't need to be played on that console devalues your purchase is an idiotic statement, because you are the one placing value in that, and you are the one determining whether or not that has value for you. So if you want to go ahead and keep playing your PS5, then go right ahead. That game coming to PC does not impact you negatively in any way, shape, or form. And in fact, the argument that people will make of, well, I'll just play it on PC, that's also a laughable one. Because we all know, if you're a PlayStation, Xbox, or Nintendo fanboy, no matter what you say or how you try to cope, you're not going to come to PC. The only thing that it does impact, though, is your childish behavior of, you can't play this because it's mine, and it's my thing, and unless you buy the same thing I bought, then you can't play it. That's literally being an actual man-child. Stop it. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you liked the video. Let me know what you guys thought about this in the comments section down below. If you want to see more, subscribe to the channel. It's been pretty insane, and I thank you so much if you do. If you don't worry. Thank you for watching. I appreciate that too. If you want to see more, check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It's at Oh No It's Alex. You can also join the Discord. The link is in the description down below. But I appreciate everything. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch! Bullshit, don't go again!